Chris Hoy going for gold. He is the reigning world champion. Now, there are 17 competitors going in the men's kilo time trial. Chris Hoy is ranked number one in the world, so he'll go last. So we'll have a long wait before we see him.
The 1 kilometre time trial is a unique event in that there's no heats. You know, you prepare for it the best you can. You step up there and you do the ride and you've only got one shot.
It is the ultimate gladiatorial challenge where each man pitches himself against that distance of 1,000 metres.
The difficult thing for Chris was that he had so much pressure to deal with, being world champion, last man off.
This was going to be a special night, you know, whoever was going to win it had to do something special.
It was just the most gripping competition that I've ever been privy to watch.
So Kelly, out of the gate.
Shane Kelly, I think, was the first to put the serious marker down when he rode a lifetime best and he raised Jason Quigley's Olympic record from the books.
101.224, let me tell you, that is the fastest time ever.
I had mentally prepared for it before. I said, right, you know, there's going to be some very fast times here. I hadn't quite expected to go that fast. Stick to the game plan, nothing to worry about. I was telling myself this, you know, part of me was thinking, oh my God, you know, what am I going to do?
Now then, what can this man do? This is the second German in the competition, Stefan Nimke, 26 years of age.
And Nimke, big, powerful man. He roars around the track and lowers the mark again.
What is he going to record? Look at that time, 101.186. He goes faster than Shane Kelly.
And that's when I had a little bit of panic and I thought, you know, you have these doubts of, this is everything I've trained for, you know, 4 years of complete dedication and sacrifice, and I might not even get a medal now.
Oh, Arnold Tunon, he's firing tonight.
He climbs on and lowers the mark even further. He goes inside 1-1.
Oh, I don't believe it. 100.896. What an unbelievable time.
I didn't even want to look at the scoreboard when he crossed the line. I heard this massive roar and I knew this was special.
The fastest ever time and a new Olympic record.
Nothing I can do about that. You know, I just have to do my own ride here.
There's not many people in the world that could have done what he did. I don't think it would have fazed me completely.
It's a very explosive movement when you jump out the gate, and you have to be sure you've got proper grip, and that was all I was thinking about, was just, right, get a good grip.
He's a kilo starter, he's the best kilo starter in the world.
So the world champion, Chris Hoy, comes out of the gate.
Got a really clean snap out of the start gate. You're not really thinking clearly, you're just trying to get out there as quickly as possible. I crossed the line and I heard this roar, and I normally don't hear anything in the race.
And he's inside the pace of Tunon!
So I knew that must have been the British supporters, and I thought, wow, I must be up here.
To do 17.9 and opening lap with a kilo is, you know, it's amazing.
Coming up to the halfway point, and he's still inside.
It's usually about 500 metres, you really start to feel the sting. I just had to keep reminding myself, you know, this is a good pain, it's a good pain, you know, you're going well here, just hang in there.
The three-quarter mark, he's 0.7 up, he's getting closer. He's rolling a bit, can he still keep this up?
Until you cross the line at the end, you really don't have any idea what's going on.
Chris Hoy's coming up to the line, what's he going to stop the clock at? Oh! Chris Hoy is the Olympic champion!
I heard the roar and I thought, partner's going, you've won it, and I thought, no, don't let yourself think that way until you're sure.
Well, he delivered, and he delivered right on cue.
I was just in total shock, and I went past, and just on the fence, on the barrier, was my dad, and my mum, and my sister, and my family, and I just looked up, I just caught the glimpse of them as I went past, and they were going mad, and I was like, so I just put my arm up, I was like, I've done it.
Gold medal, representing Great Britain, Chris Hoy.
You know, the Olympics are the be-all and end-all. It's what everyone trains for. It's what motivates you. It's what drives you on. I mean, if I had to sacrifice all my other previous wins for one Olympic gold, I would have done that. You know, that's how much it means to me.